There's audio newness afoot. Hey, PowerDirector peeps. Today, I'm gonna bring you the newness on two audio enhancements in PowerDirector 18. Audio scrubbing and the volume meter. If you plan on using these dope audio tools to help you in your next video, I want you to put hashtag audio features in the comment section below.
Here we are in PowerDirector 18. The audio features in PowerDirector 18 let you monitor your audio so you can make precise edits and produce great sound for your videos. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to monitor your audio like a boss. Let's get bossy. As you can see on the timeline, there's a clip of me running my big old mouth. And we need to make sure all the settings we need to monitor our audio are enabled. So we're going to go up here to Preferences. We're going to make sure that we're on the General tab. And we want to make sure that Show Sound Waveform in Timeline is enabled. So it should have a check mark. We also want to make sure that Play Audio While Scrubbing in the Timeline is enabled. So it should also have a check mark. Now we'll go ahead and click on OK. And then we want to go to enable our peaking meter or our volume meter. So you want to click on View. And then you want to make sure you click on Timeline Preview Volume Meter. And when you do that, right here below your preview window and to the right of all of the options, you should see a volume meter appear. Now that we got all of that out of the way, let's break down these audio features and show you how to use them. We'll start off with the waveform. The waveform is a visual representation of sound that is present on a timeline track. If it has up and down lines, then that means that there is audio present. If there are no up and down lines, then there's silence, or if they're really small, you might just have some room noise. Now you can increase or decrease the volume. All you got to do is left click on the clip, place your cursor over the white line at the bottom, and you should see that it says 0 dB at that point. Hold down your left mouse, and then you can move the volume down. As you can see, now the waveform is gone. That means that there is no sound on this timeline track for this clip. Or you can raise the volume up. Now, if you move the volume up and you see these yellow dots, move the volume line back down until those yellow dots disappear. The yellow dots mean that the audio will start clipping. Basically, it's going to make strange noises and sound all distorted, and you don't want none of that. Now, let's talk about the volume meter. The volume meter, which some of you might refer to as a peak meter, is a visual representation of the audio signal. The higher the meter, the louder the sound is. The main purpose of the peak meter is to set the audio at an audible level where it doesn't peak. You want your audio to remain in the green so that it doesn't clip. So if we play this and watch the peak meter.
Hey, PowerDirector peeps. Today, I'm going to tell you about two new audio feature enhancements in PowerDirector 18.
You can see that the audio that I have created stays within the green, which means that it is not at the highest level. It is not peaking. If I were to go ahead and raise this volume back up like I did before, until I see those yellow dots on there and play this again, it's probably going to peak.
Hey, PowerDirector peeps. Today, I'm going to tell you about two new audio feature enhancements in PowerDirector 18.
As you can see, that was all up in the yellow and the red. That is not what we want. So let's go ahead and click on the clip, place our line back over the volume meter, and bring that back down until those yellow dots are all gone. Last thing we're going to discuss is audio scrubbing. But before we do that, I want to remind you to subscribe to PowerDirector University to see great tips and tricks just like this every Saturday. If you decide to subscribe, don't forget to click on the bell to get notifications every time I upload content to YouTube. And don't forget to follow PDU tutorials on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram for even more PowerDirector love.
Now, let's get back to the breathtaking tutorial.
Audio scrubbing occurs when you drag the playhead across a segment of a waveform. The audio will play at the speed and direction you're moving the playhead. So if we go ahead and scrub this timeline, smooth this playhead over here. I'm gonna drag this.
Hey, Power Director peeps. Today, I'm gonna tell you about two new audio features.
Or I can drag it backwards. So I think you get the gist of that. This is a useful tool to help you find a specific spot in your video. Like if I wanted to split this clip right where I say, hey, Power Director peeps, I can scrub the timeline to find that. So if I scrub the timeline.
Hey, Power Director peeps.
I know that part of the waveform is where I say it. I can place my playhead right before the waveform. And I can click on split. And now if I click play, it should say, hey, Power Director peeps.
Hey, Power Director peeps. Today, I'm
good to go. And so that pretty much sums it up. You got your waveform that you can use to monitor your audio. You also have your peak meter or volume meter to monitor your audio. And then you have the lusciousness of the audio scrubbing. And that, my friends, is how you monitor your audio like a boss using Power Director 18. If you decide that you like PowerDirector 18 and you want to buy or upgrade to the software or purchase the 365 annual subscription, I will leave some links in the video description. Don't forget to drop me a comment and a like down below. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.